Hi everybody, this is Tracy Bowman from T.A. Bowman Studios and Bowman for Art on Facebook, and I'm going to do a 6x6 today. I'm going to do my bloom flowers, and here are my colors. I'm going to do two different colors. I'm going to do Blue Violet by Amsterdam with Arteza's Electric Plum. And then I'm going to do another flower that is an orange. I think I made it up, with copper and Yellow Ochre by Amsterdam. And then my leaves are going to be, what is this? Extreme Sheen Peridot with 14 karat gold and some yellowish green by Amsterdam. So I'm going to pour down my puddle, or my base paint. And I used to always wonder how much base paint do I actually put down. So I thought I'd show you my paint going down. Let me just open my paints here. Sorry. And I put my paint in a dispenser and I mix it up. It's Color Place paint by Walmart, and this is called Antique White. Ooh, that's a fair amount there. I'm usually not shy with it, so I know a lot of people like to be sparingly with it, but I like to make sure I get a really good coating and that it goes everywhere it needs to. Runs right over the edges. Usually like to spin it out pretty good too, because I don't want my bloom flowers to go way too far. And I'll take care of these bubbles here. Okay, she's looking good now. And I'll have some paper towel on hand, which is always important. Okay. Close up my paint. All right, now let's see. I guess I'll start with the purple flowers. I think I'm only gonna put two on here, two flowers, since it's only a 6x6. So you put it on off center, both of them, both of the flowers will be a little off center. It's funny, I didn't realize I did that. I dribbled a little house paint in my pink color. Silly me. So I like my paint to be mound on mound. It just flows nicely off the stick. Just a touch more. Okay. And then I'll do my flowers. I mean, my leaves, excuse me. Now that I know where those are going, I use a fair amount of paint for my leaves. Okay. And I do like my leaves to be variegated. So we'll put some other colors in there. Okay, and I like a little gold in my leaves too. Let's see. This 14 karat gold really glistens. And I like to vary where I put the off colors for my leaves so they don't clash up against one another. A little bit more bubbles. Take care of them now. And let's see, okay, we're gonna vary our flowers a little bit. This is that electric plum. It has a color shift to it. It's got a, like a little blue hint to it. And copper for the other one here. I got a little bit left in here. It looks like it needs to be thinned slightly. So when that happens, I use Josonia varnish and I'll just add a bit to it and mix it up and see if it will flow better that way. Mix it up. I didn't check these beforehand. Sorry about that. That's better. And I thought I would put a little yellow ochre in both the centers. See if we can get a nice yellow center. Let's see how that goes. Now I'm going to use Payne's Gray for my flowers, or no, my leaves, excuse me. All right, we're gonna torch slightly. I don't have much of a flame on here. How interesting is that? I probably don't have any fluid in there. I'll have to fill it up. Okay, so alrighty. I do use Australian Floetrol. I mix it by the teaspoon. So it's 3 teaspoons of Australian Floetrol to 1 paint. And I always use Amsterdam paint, pretty much always. It seems to just work really well. I also use the mini blower or the mini leaf blower. I do find it on Amazon. And I love the way it works. I blow out the leaves first. We want to skim that cell activator across. This is big blob here. We don't like this big black blob, but it'll disappear anyway. I don't have to worry about it. I don't have to worry about that. So I was thinking I would put just a spot, just a tiny spot of white cell activator on the purple ones. It might give it better, see the cells a little bit better there. I don't want much because it can change the color. I just want a spot. And here we go. There's that. And there's that. Okay. And we get the cell activator to come right down on top of that, right in the middle. So we want to be able to really show that up. And whatever flower you do last is going to be your prominent flower. So I think I'm going to do the purple one last. Right down on top of it. Okay, so cell activator is a very stretchy consistency. So once you blow it out, it has to come back. So we'll leave the flowers for a bit. The leaves have sat enough, so we can play with those, but we'll let them kind of set up by themselves. So create a little interest in the leaves. Thank you. Okay, I'm gonna spin that slightly. Oh, and those cells in the center really have, they got all three colors in there, which is really lovely. All right, we'll start with the orange one, play with the leaves. And I like to leave the center as the middle of the flower. So, and I love these skewers. I buy them on Amazon. They got a fat end and a skinny end. So I use the fat end to make my petals. And I lift straight up without dribbling. Here we go. Okay. So I see this flower coming straight out its face. So what a great center that's going to be. That did just what I wanted it to. How amazing is that? Doesn't always go that way. Oh, nice. Very, very nice. Pretty. I'm very happy with that. Nice. Okay, let's give that a spin. My spinner is a little jumpy these days. Probably needs a good cleaning. Oh, that looks great. So everyone loves it when I put in my my little heart buds. So I'm gonna put a purple one in up here. And I think I'm going to make it look like it's a bud with leaves on it. That's not dropping very easily. Why not? Let's see, do another one. Okay, we'll just draw right through that. Sweet. I love that. We're gonna leave it just like that. Ta-da! She be done. I am very happy. Let me see if I can get you down so you can see it closer. Oh, I'm quite happy with that. Look at the center of that flower. I couldn't be happier with it. The orange one is quite pretty. Everyone loves the orange ones because it makes them feel like they're looking at butterflies. But my oh my, that purple flower is really something. Okie dokie, we're done for today. I hope you enjoyed this video, and keep painting. Bye for now.